Hey, what's up everyone? So you may notice that I sound a little bit different. The reason for that is because I got a new microphone. I'm super excited about it because my old one was a little bit of a pain to set up and I bought three microphones trying to find one that worked. But I'm really happy with this one and I think the audio quality is pretty good. So in today's video, I've decided that I want to start a new series. Obviously, it's still a Hypixel Skyblock series because, well, I'm in Hypixel. But in this series, I'm going to progress through the game and you can see exactly what I'm doing and how I'm doing it. So why do I feel like I need to start over? Well, it's complicated. There are a lot of people who are currently stuck in early game or stuck in mid game and are trying to get to late game. And I really want to make a guide about how to get out of the mid game, but I'm not in the mid game myself. So not only would it be a potentially unreliable source of information, it would also be really difficult to recreate. Now, if I was actually making the jump from the mid game to the late game, then it would be a lot easier to recreate because I'm not recreating it. So I won't continue this series if you guys don't want to see it, so just let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. Sorry about the long intro, let's get right into it. Right, so Hypixel Skyblock, you basically spawn on this island, you have to build over to that island, and then you go to the hub. I'm enjoying this game. This is fun. So I'm not even going to try to do anything on my island, I'm just going to try to speed bridge over to the hub island because I'm so cool. Oh my gosh, look at me go. Oh my god, I didn't actually mess that up. I thought I would. So the first thing I recommend doing when you start any Skyblock game is going over and punching some wheat. Wheat is a really good money source for early game, like when you first start. This is because you can get a lot of it really quickly, and it actually sells for, you know, a decent amount of money. So while I'm farming wheat, I just wanted to briefly talk about what I'm going to be doing in this Skyblock series. This is not a Skyblock series that I want to grind for. This is a Skyblock series that is meant to get to late game as fast as I possibly can. So I probably won't really be doing any slayers, unless it's to get maybe like the Radiant Power Orb, and I definitely won't be doing much farming, and I probably won't even be doing all that much zealot grinding. My goal is to get to late mid game or maybe early end game. Not even 5 minutes later and we have a full stack full of wheat and seeds. Make sure you save 80 wheat so you can craft a wheat minion, but go ahead and sell the rest to the NPC. Now we have a total of 1,700 coins to our name. With this money, let's purchase an undead sword, a set of iron armor, promising axe, 3 gold so that we can purchase a golden pickaxe, and go ahead and put the rest of the money in the bank. You lose half your coins when you die, so that's why we put the money in the bank. Now, let's quickly mine 80 cobblestone, and then go ahead and mine 80 coal. And 1, 2, and that is actually one more than 80 coal. Now you're gonna head over to the gold mine, talk to the lazy miner, and then run down the mine and turn right whenever possible. As you can see, I'm just hugging the right wall, and I'm gonna keep hugging it all the way down until I see the lazy miner's pickaxe, which should be right about here. There it is. We got the lazy miner's pickaxe because it's an iron pickaxe that comes with smelting touch 1. This is the annoying part. You're gonna need to mine 80 iron and 80 gold. One way to make your mining a little bit easier is to go back up to the surface and talk to this villager. His name is Rusty, and he is supposed to be a janitor. In reality, he's much more useful than a villager and can actually apply telekinesis to your tools. Telekinesis basically just makes it so that whatever you mine goes directly into your inventory. So basically, you can see that if I mine this iron, it goes directly into my inventory rather than dropping on the floor like it usually would. During the time you were mining, you should have accumulated a few hundred coins from mining because you leveled up your mining skill. So go ahead and return to the hub and put your coins in the bank. Then go ahead and return to the gold mine, and at the entrance, keep running straight. Do not make any turns. The portal to the deep caverns is literally straight from where the spawn is. Now, if you're anything like me, you might be reconsidering your life choices after mining 80 iron and 80 gold without efficiency on your pickaxe. So go ahead and jump off that cliff now. No, seriously, from the portal, turn right, go down here, and then you're gonna stand on this block right here. Now we are aiming for that corner right there. If we jump into that corner and hug it all the way down, you'll notice that we unlock everything. Talk to the lift operator. Oh, I'm so dumb. So ignore what I just said. Go down, talk to the lift operator, and then do that jump that we did. While we have already been to the zones, I forgot that you have to talk to the lift operator first. It's okay though, because you just hug that corner again and go all the way down. And now if you talk to the lift operator, you can see, please don't kill me. And now if we talk to the lift operator, you can see that we can now go down to any location we want. I know it seems crazy, but I'm human too, and I can definitely make mistakes. Head on down to the Lapis Quarry, and you're going to need to mine, I believe it was 2 stacks of Lapis Lazuli. If there's any zombies coming your way, don't be afraid to stab them. You're going to need to kill Lapis zombies anyway later, so this will just save you some time. While I'm at 2 stacks of Lapis, and I forget how much you need to mine exactly. It might be 4 stacks, but I don't remember. Oh, there we go. I just got some lapis armor leggings. This is exactly why we were killing lapis zombies. Oh my gosh, I got a second pair of lapis armor leggings. Also, I was correct in saying that you do need 4 stacks of lapis. There we go, there's a lapis armor helmet. And another lapis armor pants, okay. Another thing you can do is trade your extra armor pieces for armor pieces you don't have. So I would ask if anyone in my lobby has a chest plate or boots. So Sword Boy Pat says he has some lapis armor boots, so I'll give him some lapis armor leggings. Yes, I got it. That actually didn't take as long as I thought it would. And now we're gonna go back to the hub. Now this only applies if you got an extra piece of lapis armor, but lapis armor actually tends to sell pretty well in the auction house. So go ahead and switch to a buy it now auction, put in your lapis armor, and sell it for, I would say, about 3,500, and there you go. And don't worry about enchanting it yet, we're actually going to get rid of the lapis armor pretty quick, it's just meant to make it a little bit easier in the deep caverns. At this point, you should have also probably collected enough rotten flesh for a zombie minion. You can also sell any extra items you've collected, because you will not be needing them. And as you can see, my lapis armor leggings sold, so that's a quick 3,500 coins. And yeah, we have got 7,250 coins in the bank. For this next step, you're going to need a bow, so go ahead and just buy a regular bow and a couple stacks of arrows. Our next step involves heading back to the deep caverns, so go ahead and do that. And believe me, I know we spent a lot of time in the lapis quarry, but don't worry, we are not going to have to spend that much time in the pigman's den. This time, you only need to mine 4 stacks of redstone. Oh, you only need to mine 2 stacks of redstone, actually. And just like that, we're done. No, no, no. Oh god, they're everywhere. No, no, no. No! Next, we're gonna go to the slime hill. Here, you are going to need to mine 80 emeralds and also collect 80 slime balls. These smaller slimes you can just kill with your sword, but you are gonna need to use your bow on the bigger slimes. And the reason for that is, as you can see, if I try to melee this slime, he ends up hitting me and now I die. Diamond reserve. In the diamond reserve, you're gonna wanna get 80 bones and 80 diamonds. The diamond reserve will definitely be one of the trickier places that you visit, and you will probably die a few times. But unless you're doing some hardcore Skyblock challenge, that's fine. And we just need to mine one more diamond. Thank you, please die. And no, looks like I'm gonna die. So I only died 27 times. I don't know that my Minecraft character is enjoying this. And the last floor is the Obsidian Sanctuary. If you really want to spend all of your time fighting these monsters and continuously dying while trying to mine obsidian with a diamond pickaxe, I wish you the very best of luck. Personally, I'll be passing on the obsidian minion. With or without the obsidian, we still have a lot of materials. Now my next step is going to be to craft all the wooden tools that I need to make all these minions. Zombie minion, slime minion, skeleton minion, wheat minion, emerald minion, diamond minion, gold minion, redstone minion, iron minion, coal minion, cobblestone minion, and finally a lapis minion. Now you may be wondering to yourself, why did we just craft all of those random minions? Well, as you can see, we just unlocked a 6th minion slot, and we only need to craft 3 more unique minions to unlock our 7th minion slot. I personally like to dedicate a chest to all the minions so I can keep track of which ones I have. It has also just come to my attention that we completely forgot about this cobblestone minion. This minion is actually useless to us. The reason for that is because we don't actually start with a cobblestone minion 1 craft. So unless you plan on keeping 80 cobblestone, this guy can just go in the void. No! Next up, go ahead and buy 3 golden ingots and sell your promising axe. Go over to the librarian, and you're going to want to buy 1.5 stacks of books. Actually, you're going to need 1 extra as well. And now you're going to craft 32 bookshelves, and then place them to make a 3x3 square in the center. But there's nothing in the middle. Yeah, remember how I said you didn't have to worry about obsidian? Well, I did something that most people would call lying. But in all honesty, I totally forgot that you actually do need 4 obsidian. Head on down to the diamond reserve and mine 5 diamonds. Craft a diamond pickaxe, and for potentially the most painful thing we've done yet, try to mine 4 obsidian. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now do you see why I don't really want to mine 80? Oh great, my island spawn is actually inside of this bookshelf. Excuse me? Oh, what? Why was it? Okay, fine. Put down your enchanting table and throw in your golden axe. Destroy a couple of bookshelves until you have the level of an enchant that you need, and continue cycling through until you get to efficiency 5. Take a stroll through the graveyard. Ideally, you would do this in the daytime, but I'm a big boy, so I can do it at night. And head on over to the spider's den. Go ahead and mine 80 gravel. If I was smart, I would have brought in a shovel, but I'm not smart, and I didn't. Compared to everything else we've grinded for today, this should be pretty easy. After you've mined your 80 gravel, go ahead and start killing some spiders. You are going to need 80 string. A little bit of a pro tip here, you can see I only have 50 string, but I did actually unlock the spider minion. In reality, you do only need to grind for 50 string, but it is nice to have 80. However, we do have a nice NPC here who does happen to sell string, so you can buy the other 30 string from him. After you've cheesed the last 30 string you need to craft the spider minion, go ahead and make your way up to the top of the spider's den. Our next stop is going to be the Blazing Fortress. Welcome to the Blazing Fortress. If you can somehow get past the wither skeletons and you find yourself in a room with netherwork, go ahead and mine all the netherwork. Once again, you only need 80 to be able to craft the minion. I personally wouldn't worry too much about getting a blaze minion or a magma minion because they are both very difficult to obtain, especially when you only have lapis armor. Instead, I would worry about getting a quartz minion. Oh yeah, and you also need to mine 1,000 glowstone. Please don't hurt me. I'm only a couple minutes in and I've already mined 5 stacks. You're gonna need 16 though. Oh my gosh, we finally did it. Wow, that sucked. And now we need to go kill a single blaze so we can craft a brewing stand. Yes, we got a blaze rod. And now we can craft some of the minions that we collected. There's our 7th minion slot. And you mined plenty of glowstone, so you can probably craft a glowstone minion too. Unfortunately, we do have one more grind, but it's going to be much easier than the glowstone. Just remember that when you want to brew haste 3 potions after this, you're not going to have to do this. And there we go, the haste potion. Head on over to your local alchemist and purchase, please let me purchase things, and purchase 3 water bottles. And remember how I made you get the blaze rod? Well, unknown to me, that was completely unnecessary. I'm so smart. Oh yeah, I might have forgotten to mention that you should keep a redstone. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, and you also should have collected enough coal that you can upgrade your coal minion again. Put down your brewing stand, add your water bottles and your nether wart, and while that's brewing, go ahead and craft your enchanted glowstone dust. Add your coal, add your enchanted glowstone dust, and finally add your redstone. And now you have 3 haste 3 potions that'll last for 8 minutes. And really quick, there's one quest that you should complete because it's really going to be helpful. Go over to the Iron Forager and buy a iron pickaxe with smelting touch 1. Head on over to the deep caverns and go down to the lapis quarry. Here's the lapis miner, and if you click on him, he'll say he broke his pickaxe. If you bring him a new pickaxe, he will gladly give you a compactor. Next step, go ahead and craft 6 wooden axes. Head on past the lumberjack and continue down this path. Hop onto this launch pad to head over to the park. Drink your haste 3 potion. And you'll see that you can now insta-break wood. You'll also be able to level up your foraging skill, which you need to level up in order to access the bazaar. So go ahead and craft your birch minion 1, 2, and then keep mining so you can craft a tier 3 and a tier 4. And now I'm going to do the exact same thing, but with spruce wood. And there is my spruce 4 minion, and here's my dark oak minion 4, here's my acacia minion 4, and here's my jungle minion 4. Unfortunately, I didn't have enough haste 3 potions to last as long as I would have liked, so I decided to just brew another batch. Oak wood is a really important collection because it contains the storages for minions. So in this first session of foraging oak, I really recommend getting to the medium storage. 5,000 oak wood is quite a lot, but it should not be as bad as the glowstone. Oh wow, we're already foraging 13. So I would recommend starting with 10 small storages. This way you can at least put a small storage next to each of your minions. So I actually just realized that I forgot to put the redstone dust into my brewing stand, which means that my potions lasted 5 minutes less than they should have. So I made some good progress towards the medium storage, but I think it was about time for me to stop foraging anyway, because I'm pretty burned out. Dang, we got to foraging 13 though. I will of course purchase some oak wood from the lumber merchant just so I don't have to grind for it, and deposit the rest of the money in my bank. So I got my 10 small storages and enough for almost 2 medium storages. Just overall, I would say I did pretty decent. Now, if I'm in a hurry for minion space, usually I just bridge out 1 block and then I bridge out by 2 and put down the minion. So I'd put down a minion right there, and I would also put down a minion right here, and I just continue that pattern out. So I currently have 8 minion slots. So personally, I'm going to put the compactor in the redstone minion so I can unlock some of the accessory bags. I never said we were done, but you must have thought we were getting close. No, We need 2 auto smelters. That is not bad though. We can just go mine that cobblestone pretty much instantly. Now the reason we wanted these 2 auto smelters was because a gold and an iron minion usually just produce the iron or gold ore. But if we put an auto smelter in it, then it actually produces the ingots. 1, 2, 3. And I'm putting the auto smelter in it. 4. Also putting the auto smelter in it. 5, 6, 7. And I'm gonna put the compactor and the redstone minion so that I can produce as much as I possibly can. Well, that was quite the grind. I really hope you learned something in this video. I tried to make it as much of like a Skyblock tutorial as I could while still making a lot of progress in the game. Let me know what you guys think of this series, because I'm not sure if you're gonna like it or not. Also, I have a Discord now. I'll make sure to put the link in the description. So yeah, thank you guys a ton for watching. Make sure to comment, like, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.